survey says it's 6 o'clock. Time for Family Feud. Now, here's your host, Grant Denyer.
With us tonight. Welcome to Family Feud, where two families will battle it out for $10,000 and the chance to win a brand new Mitsubishi Outlander SUV. And all they need to do is guess the answers to some pretty easy questions. So, let's meet our families. First up, our carryover champions here for their second night from Victoria, the Porter family. I reckon second night's easier. Ooh, so yeah. You'll be just hitting your straps tonight. Yeah. Remind Australia who's on board.
My sister-in-law, Catherine. My brother-in-law, Brad, and my brother-in-law, Mark.
Great to have you guys back and ready to take them on tonight from South Australia. It's the Frauenfelder family. Yeah. That's fun to say.
It is.
The Frauenfelder family on Fabulous Family Feud. Far out, man.
Fabulous.
Who's on board your team?
Here's my brother, Scott, my sister, Kate, and my daughter, Taylor.
Cool. Great to have you guys here tonight. Righto. Team captains, let's play the feud. We surveyed 100 people and the top 7 answers are on the board. How do you get rid of a ghost in your house? Camille?
Seance.
A seance. Ooh. Oh, good try, but no. Kelly?
A priest.
Let's have a look. Right, pass or play? Pass, okay. Ever seen one? Do you know of anybody who's ever seen one?
No, but we had some pretty bad luck for a while and my mother-in-law used to tell me to tell it just to go away.
And did it go away?
No, so I'm not going to go with that. I'm going to go... Oh, I've got something about onions.
Onions? Mm. What, like you cook them or you just have
you
them in the
room? You plant onions.
And that makes them go away?
I've heard it.
First strike. Brad?
You're going to have to decide to go away.
How do you get rid of a ghost in your house? You tell it to nick off. Second strike. Frauenfelder, let's get ready for an option. Mark.
The pressure.
How about you?
Never seen one.
Would you like to?
Yeah, I think it's under the right circumstances. If we could go out and have a drink together or, you know, have a boogie, you know. That'd be good fun. Yeah, yeah. Move. I would.
If you had a ghost, you move house. Good. Literal thinking. Camille.
Well, I'm going to think outside the box that it could work. Get the Ghostbusters in.
Yeah. Who are you going to call? Ghostbusters. What a movie. What a series of movies.
Apparently they're doing another one.
Oh, I know!
Yes!
How awesome!
Yeah.
I love Bill Murray. Catherine.
Yeah. Oh, pray.
You pray?
Pray
nice.
That they go away.
Oh, third strike. Frauenfelders. Talia, what would you say?
I reckon salt. You put salt around your house.
I called you Talia. Sorry, Taylor.
That's okay.
Kate.
Lighting incense.
Excellent. Scott.
Cleansing.
Cleansing, nice. Kelly, some wonderful options. Sounds like they're quite experienced at ghostbusting.
Scary, really. I think I'm going to stick with Taylor and go with the salt ring because I'm a bit of a,
you're a bit of
supernatural fan.
You're an ethereal kind of... Really? Yeah. Have you ever seen something?
Oh, no, just the TV show.
Yeah. Let's see if we get you some points. No! Porter's grabbed the early lead. Remaining answers are... Sage. You put it on your back like you're a homemade ghostbuster and just try and... Quick, close it! Like that? Yeah. I don't know. Australia, whoever we surveyed, you're weird. 54-0 right now. Look, if one of these families goes on to win for 5 nights in a row, they'll be driving home the amazing all-new Mitsubishi Outlander. This family SUV seats 5 comfortably and is packed with features including touchscreen audio, CVT auto with paddle shift and eco drive support. Now, for everyone playing along at home, I want the top answer to this one. Name a cartoon bird. We'll be back to compare answers on Family Feud in just a moment. two families are still going head-to-head for the chance to win $10,000. Now, before the break, I asked, name a cartoon bird. The top answer was...
Tweety Bird!
Nice work, everybody. Righto, give me Catherine, give me Scott. Let's play the Feud. We surveyed 100 people and the top 8 answers are on the board. Name something you can inflate. Scott.
Balloon.
Balloon. Top answer, pass or play.
Hi.
Play. Good. Now, speaking of something a little spooky, what do you do while he's sleeping?
I sleepwalk.
You sleepwalk?
Occasionally.
And what do you get up to whilst you're walking whilst asleep?
Well, I wake up in the morning to find that I occasionally get up to spring cleaning.
Wow, that's kind of like the best thing that could happen.
I know. I wish I did it every night.
But... do you want to come and stay at my house?
Sure.
That's really cool, because you're doing chores that no one really wants to do, and you don't even know you've done them.
I know. That's
ace.
Great. Thanks.
That's a bonus. Something you can inflate.
Swimming pool.
A blow-up pool.
Yeah, blow-up, that's it.
Taylor's happy with that.
Yeah.
Something you can inflate.
A jumping castle.
Yes, you can.
Yeah.
Yes, you can. Something you can inflate.
Tire.
You inflate a tire. Mm-hmm. Can't drive on them flat. It's a pretty bumpy ride if you do.
Absolutely.
You inflate a tire.
An air mattress.
Yeah, you do. When you've got guests that come over.
Or camping.
Yeah, or you're camping.
Yeah.
Good answer, is it there? Did you just have a little minor panic when you realised it was you again?
Yes, I did. That came around too quick.
Something you can inflate.
A bra. Sorry.
Wow. Let's see if that's on the board.
Oh, sorry.
First strike, Taylor.
At the show, how you can get, like, novelty items, like a big inflatable hammer.
Inflatable hammer's not too bad. I know what you mean. In your show bag.
Yeah.
Ooh, second strike. OK, porters, have a think. They might be able to steal if you get another strike. Kelly?
Pool toys.
Like the old horsey, pool horsey thing. Mm. Yeah. Let's see if that's there. Scott?
A ball.
You inflate a ball, of course. Makes a lot of sense. Frauenfelders, you trail right now, but there's only one left. You've done a dynamic job to knock out all of those bar one. Kate, it's up to you. Two strikes down.
Inflate toys.
You inflate some toys. Toys in general. Let's see if toys are there. Sorry not. Porter. Porters. Mark.
Floaties.
Floaties, nice. Brad?
A raft.
Excellent. Catherine?
I like floaties.
You like floaties? Camille, your choice?
I'll go with one of those blow-up rafts.
A blow-up raft.
Boat.
Let's have a look. Is number 6 a blow-up raft? No, it's not. Porters miss out. Frauenfelders get some points. Number 6 was...
Tough.
You can never pick them. You can just never pick them. 54-77 are our points right now. Double points time. So give me Brad, give me Kate. Let's do it. I did not think that. Did you guys think that? That one came out of the blue. We surveyed 100 people and the top 7 answers are on the board. Name a food you associate with Christmas time. Brad.
Pudding.
Pudding.
Cherries.
Cherries? No. Oh. What do you mean in season? Yeah, that's what you mean. Brad.
No, I've got to answer, darling.
No, pass or play.
Play.
Camille's going, Brad.
I thought I'd have one more go at getting the top answer.
You just calm down and let somebody else have a go. Take
My turn.
Yes, Mark.
Turkey.
Oh, yeah.
Turkey's good.
Oh, yeah.
Turkey's great. Oh, these novices, Camille, who don't know how to play the game.
Ooh.
Funny. Name a food you associate with Christmas time.
Shortbread?
Yeah. Mama's making shortbread. Negatory. Ghost Rider. Yep. Food you associate with Christmas time.
Christmas cake.
Christmas cake. Now you get another turn.
Now I get a turn, okay. I couldn't get the second one though, or the first one.
Food you associate with Christmas time.
I'll say ham.
Oh, yeah.
Yum.
Leg of ham.
Off the bone. Food you associate with Christmas time, Mark?
Pavlova.
Oh.
just you said it with a massive question mark at the end. Let's have a look. Second strike. Frauenfelders. Have a think of an option in case you get to steal. Camille, your turn.
I think mince pie. Mince pies.
Mince pie. Food you associate with Christmas time. Is mince pie on the board? Oh. No, it's not. Frauenfelders, your turn. Taylor.
Candy canes.
Candy cane. Kate.
Prawns.
Prawns. Nice. Scott.
Custard.
Custard. Kelly. Not bad options.
All right, we have them all. I'll stick with Kate and go prawns.
It's kind of like the alternative. Let's see if it gets you guys another bag of points. Is prawn on the board? No, it's not. Porters get some points. Takes you to 232, number 7. Ooh, a trifle.
Roast.
Gingerbread. Well, there you go. So 77 to 232 right now. Look, if you love Family Feud, then you'll love 10 Play, where you can catch all the highlights and the fun stuff that kind of goes on behind the scenes and doesn't quite make it to air. And you can also play along with our official Family Feud game as well. Head to 10 Play and look up Family Feud for all the details. Triple points and we come back right here on Family Feud. See you in a sec. Now, the Frauenfelders on 77. The Porters, at the moment, our carryover chap, a little happy about being in the lead on 232. It's the family who gets the 300 points right now. Could go on to our fast money and win $10,000, and we're playing for triple points. So give me Mark. Give me Taylor. Let's play. We surveyed 100 people, and the top 8 answers are on the board. Name something you associate with an athlete. Taylor.
Sport.
Sport's good. Ooh. Mark.
Running.
Is running there? Pass or play? You want to run a marathon on every continent?
Yes.
Have you run a marathon yet?
Not quite. No.
Maybe you should just try one first.
Yeah.
Because you might not like it.
Before I die. That's bucket list. Yeah.
Nice work. Something you associate with an athlete.
Fitness.
Good answer.
Well.
Top answer. Adrian.
Training. You need to do a lot of training.
You do, if you're going to be good at it. Brad.
Look, I think athletes have to wear clothing, so I'm going to say, I'll say a top, a singlet top.
A singlet top. Fred, not Brad. Mark. Something you associate with an athlete?
Olympic Games.
The Olympic Games. Mm. It's the event of
the
athletes.
The epitome.
Camille?
I think you have to be really committed, so commitment.
Commitment is not a bad answer. Second strike. Frauenfelders, this could be you back in the game. Catherine.
Quite often athletes get injuries.
So an athlete...
go with injuries.
Who pushes it too hard can be injured. Third strike. Wow. Frauenfelders, you need this. Triple point round. Hit me, Taylor.
Medals.
Not bad. Kate.
Competing.
Scott.
Competing.
Excellent. You're the boss. Definitive moment.
Competing.
Competing it is. Here we go. Ready to do it? Well, let's have a look, for the steal is competing on the board for the Frauenfelders. No! They miss out. Porter's become our champs again. Remaining 8-7. Sweat. Oh, dear. Medals. Hand muscles. Who said medals? Taylor said medals. And they didn't listen. Kelly.
Thank you.
Scott.
Thank
you.
Kate.
Thank you.
Taylor. Oh, you guys came, you saw, you tried it, you just missed it by that much. It's time to say goodbye, but you won't go home empty-handed. We're going to give you guys a $1,000 Wish gift card to be shared between you, and the card can be redeemed at Woolies Supermarkets, Masters Home Improvement, Big W and other participating stores. And guess what? You get to take home the brand new Family Feud board game. A great Christmas gift available at Toys R Us, Games World and Mind Games as well. So they are the Frauenfelder family. Sorry, guys. Good try. Porters, fast money. Let's go. Righto. Here we go. $10,000. We missed last time. Let's do it this time. You're back that way. Bit of a change in the roster, I see. You ready?
Yes.
Up top. Fast money. Family Feud. We'll be back in just a moment for $10,000.
Family Feud is on Facebook and Twitter. Plus, you can find us on YouTube and catch all the action on 10Play.
He's clapping because he's a happy man. And once again, our champions tonight, it's Fast Money. And here on The Feud, let's see if the Porter family can now win some cash, OK? That sounds pretty good, doesn't it? Mm. If you and Catherine get 200 points or more between you, you'll do just that. Take home $10,000. Catherine is now in a soundproof booth and can't hear your answers, but she looks pretty happy in there. I'm going to ask you 5 questions. Going to give you 20 seconds to answer. If you pass, we'll come back at this time, and the clock starts at the end of the first question. That make sense?
Mm-hmm, yep.
20 seconds on the clock, please. Good luck, Brady. Describe an activity people do on their holiday.
Swim.
Name something you find in the bush.
Kangaroos.
Name someone who's up before sunrise.
Milkman.
Name a famous prince.
Charles.
Name something you do on your body that never... Name something on your body that never stops growing.
Fingernails.
Excellent. Good job. Let's go.
Good job.
You answered that very strongly and confidently and looked quite comfortable. Mm-hmm. Was it
didn't,
like that?
No, it wasn't actually. I didn't think I was that comfortable.
Oh, OK. Describe an activity people do on their holiday. You said swim. Nice summer location, which Sundays, who knows? Survey says. Ooh. Fantastic.
Good.
Very good. Name something you find in the bush. You said kangaroos. Survey says. Excellent. Name someone who's up before sunrise. You said the milkman is. Survey says.
Ooh.
3. A famous prince. You said.
Prince Charles.
Survey says 23 is not bad. And name something on your body that never stops growing. And you said fingernails. I like the answer. Survey says magic. Ooh. Really close to the 100 mark is spot on. Well done, Brad. To the board. Welcome back. You got a great shot at this. You only need 106 now to get $10,000. So, you know, nearly half the work has been done, which is exactly what you need to do. I'm going to ask you the same 5 questions. You're the second player and it's a little harder, so I'll give you an extra 5 seconds, OK? If you pass on a question, I'll ask it again if there's time. Mm-hmm. And if you repeat an answer that's already there, you'll hear this sound and I'll ask you to try again. Can we remind everybody of Brad's answers? And 25 seconds on the clock too, please. The time starts from the end of the first question. Good luck. Describe an activity people do on their holiday.
Swim.
Try again.
Sunbake.
Name something you find in the bush.
Animals.
Name someone who's up before sunrise.
Me.
Name a famous prince.
Charles.
Try again.
William.
Name something on your body that never stops growing.
Hair.
Fantastic. Great job. Let's go. Enjoy that?
It's fun. Out in the back.
Just not this bit. Listen, enjoying the music in the comforts of our soundproof booth.
Yeah.
This bit, not so much.
Can you win money for that?
No, I don't think you can. Okay. It's not a singing contest out there. Describe an activity people do on their holiday. You said they sunbake. Feels pretty good. Mm. Survey says 12. Excellent. Brad had the top answer. That was swim. Name something you find in the bush. You said animals are in the bush. The survey says 17. Tree was the top answer. You find trees in the bush. Name someone who's up before sunrise. Why's everybody laughing? You said, oh, that's why. I've forgotten your answer. How many Australians do you think would know that you are up before sunrise?
Probably none.
Well, oh, your family would. Oh, were your family surveyed? No. This is probably not going to be that good for you then. Survey says...
Oh! People know me!
Yay!
Yeah!
Well done. But a bakeout was the top answer.
Of course.
Now we're closing in, aren't we? Mm. Does it feel achievable at this stage or not?
75? No.
Name a famous prince. You said Prince William.
George?
Survey says 29. Hey, you said Prince Harry. You better have the top answer.
Okay. Harry.
Oh, feels like a long shot, but let's not give up hope. Name something on your body that never stops growing. You said hair. Look, the thing is, it's a cool answer because it's the top answer. However, is it enough? That's a big chunk of points that you now need to get yourself over the line. Get to 200, you get $10,000. It's that simple. Do you think you have $10,000?
I've probably spent $10,000 getting rid of hair.
Would you like to be refunded for that?
I would love to be refunded.
Fingers crossed, everybody. Fingers crossed. The survey says...
for all